Congressman, lawmakers just passed this deal. Is this bipartisanship going to continue?
It would be nice, but I don't think so. The fact is that there are two instances in which Democrats have leverage and can force a bipartisan approach, and that is involving the debt ceiling and also keeping the government open and on funding. So there are not going to be too many opportunities to kind of force the Republicans' hands, but we now have an opportunity again in December.
Were you surprised when you saw the images of President Trump and Minority Leader Schumer, as well as Nancy Pelosi, top Democrat in the House of Representatives, inside of the Oval Office? I mean, what were you thinking?
Well, I've ceased to be surprised at anything that happens in this White House, but clearly that was an interesting departure from pattern. They have not usually consulted with Democratic leadership on anything. So that was good to see, and it was interesting that the president, and apparently what was a very spontaneous gesture, decided to accept the Democratic position as opposed to the Republican one.
What did Democratic leaders tell members after this deal was made?
Well, basically they told us that they went in there, that Republicans wanted an 18-month increase in the debt ceiling, and so they wanted to take it past the next election, and it was a battle of leverage, or for leverage. And in this instance, Nancy kept saying, you know, in the Congress, the coin of the realm is votes, speaking to Secretary Mnuchin. And if you have the votes, then this meeting's over. You can do whatever you want. But if you don't have the votes, it's going to be 3 months.
So what's going to happen in December? Because a lot of investors are watching this. They're watching the political uncertainty unraveling in Washington, D.C. What's going to happen with regards to the debt limit on December 8th?
Well, I think, you know, we're committed to raising the debt limit, as is Senator McConnell and also Speaker Ryan. So I don't think that's actually going to be a problem. The question is how long and to what amount. You know, it was interesting that President Trump indicated an interest in possibly eliminating the debt ceiling.
Yeah.
We're one of, I think, two countries in the world that has one.
And you guys would love that. Democrats would love that.
We would love it. And, of course, we've raised it 80-something times over the past 40 years, and it used to be routine. But it really serves no legitimate purpose as far as I can tell. So it'd be interesting if that becomes part of the discussion.
Yeah. If it does, what would Democrats be willing to give up? I mean, is this going to be tied to wall funding? Are we going to get to the point in December and deal with things like DACA and the wall?
We're going to definitely deal with DACA. I think our caucus is committed to a policy in which if they want to keep the government open, then we're going to pass the DREAM Act. I don't think we would say that about the debt ceiling. I think people think that's much too important to negotiate with other policies. As far as the wall is concerned, the wall is non-negotiable with Democrats in any context.
Final question, and you know, obviously you're a Democrat, but just judging your counterparts across the aisle, I'm wondering if you think Republican leadership right now is weakened as a result of the president's short-term deal with the opposing party.
Well, I think that remains to be seen. Clearly, it was a blow to their leadership. And
you seem happy about that.
And I think it was almost, I have a feeling it was almost President Trump pushing back against the narrative that was occurring Republican leaders in both the House and the Senate had decided that he was irrelevant to the legislative process, that the president was, and they were going to do their own thing. I suspect that what the president did was to push back a little bit on that.
That's a really interesting point. What have you heard from your constituents, though, from Democrats in your district about the short-term deal? Do they like it? Do they not like it? Do they like you working with President Trump?
It's too soon. I haven't heard anything.
Well, you're on that plane, and we will not have you miss your plane.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
This weekend, I'll find out how it feels.
Thank you for coming on. We appreciate it.
Sure, my pleasure.